Hey guys, how's everyone doing? I'm Enemy Intensity, and welcome back to my channel. So this video has been requested several times, and I'm sorry that it took so long for me to make it, considering this is the sequel to my favorite anime of all time. So I apologize, but due to work and applying for schools, it did get a little pushed back. But anyway, today we're actually going to be talking about my first impressions of the first three episodes of Cardcaptor Sakura, Clear Card. So, you know, maybe this is a good thing. Instead of just talking about one episode, we get to talk about three, so we can actually have a good discussion. So maybe it's good that I waited a little while. Cardcaptor Sakura is definitely my favorite series of all time. I absolutely love it. It is just so sentimental to me. It means so much to me. And when I heard that there was going to be a sequel, I was like, huh? What? Are you sure? Why? Like, what else are they going to do? But once again, Clamp has surprised me and actually made Clear Card to be just as great as the original Cardcaptor Sakura. These first three episodes are pretty much the exact, like, first volume. So if you read the first volume of the Cardcaptor Sakura Clear Card manga, you know what to expect in the first three episodes if you haven't watched them already. Also, vice versa. If you watched the first three episodes, you know what to expect in the first volume of manga. Madhouse actually did an amazing job adapting the manga. Honestly, it's like panel for panel. It's gorgeous. It's just so cute. And they're just doing such an amazing job. Just had to say that just before we start talking about the episodes. You can actually watch Cardcaptor Sakura Clear Card on Crunchyroll, and there's actually a brand new dub. I think already episode one is out on Funimation. Monica Ryle is actually Sakura herself, so check that out if you like dubs. It's definitely great to see Cardcaptor Sakura being dubbed once again here in the United States, especially with such amazing voice actors. So go check that out if you like dubs. But anyway, so yeah, the first three episodes, where do I start? Honestly, let's talk about the visuals first. Madhouse is doing such an amazing job with the animation. We're talking about, like, not just in the opening sequence and the ending sequence, throughout the entire episodes. We are just talking about clear, crisp animation. I absolutely love it, especially when Sakura is using her staff and trying to catch the cards and things like that. She is doing wow. Like, everything is so smooth, it looks gorgeous, and I gotta admit, Clear Card is definitely more vibrant and bright compared to the original Cardcaptor Sakura, so the visuals are so much more brighter. I'm not complaining because it still looks so stunning. So I think Madhouse is doing such a great job with the visuals, just have to say that. Also, opening and ending song. First of all, the ending song is really cute, and I love how there's like a bunch of like drawings, like it looks like a crayon almost. It's just really cute. Like, just watch it, okay? And also, the soundtrack that is being used for Clear Card is like a massive throwback to the original as well, because you are basically using the soundtrack from the original. There are so many pieces that I heard in Clear Card that I was like, am I watching the original Cardcaptor Sakura right now? Like, it's just so great to have pieces of the original in Clear Card. They know that Cardcaptor Sakura fans expect to see things from the original series, and they're just putting little things, Madhouse is putting little things that just bring it back to the original. And I gotta admit, I love that. Madhouse is doing something really awesome in the sense that they are bringing something that's over 10 years old and making it feel brand new. And maybe that's not just from the way, you know, the manga, you know, since there's a new manga or whatever. No, because in that case, they would be making it the same way as they made the original, but that's not the case. They are taking this new material from this old series and making it feel brand new by making it their own. So even though this series gives you the nostalgia feels, and it's definitely very nostalgic, you know, it still has this feeling of something new, and I like how they're able to mix that, you know, make something new while still retaining its nostalgia. I absolutely love how Madhouse is doing this, so just gotta say, pat on the back for Madhouse. But anyway, the first three episodes were really, really great. I loved everything about them. The dialogue, of course, voice acting is spot on, and Sakura's hue is still, you know, very prominent in the series. I definitely love all of their interactions in the anime, although some people are not getting that much screen time, which I think need more. In particularly Lee and Ariel, but we'll get to them soon. So yeah, we basically encounter Sakura losing all of her cards, all of her Sakura cards, which is a big problem, okay? So she does not have her Sakura cards anymore. They all turn clear. Doesn't that make sense when Silas clear card now? Now she got a brand new key, you know, a brand new wand, and she is basically going to be capturing brand new cards, probably 50 new ones, because she lost 50 of her own cards. So I don't know how long this anime is slated to be, but she has a lot of catching to do. We definitely see three cards get captured within the first three episodes, and these cards are very different in the sense that they don't resemble people. Like, not all of Sakura's cards resembled people, but take an example like the Windy. The Windy resembled a person. Now we have a card, the Gale, which is still kind of like the same element, but it doesn't look anything like a person, and it doesn't even resemble anything pretty much, although it does look like it has an eye. So it's like, even though what she is capturing may be the same element, or, you know, this kind of almost similar to one of her cards, the way that they behave and the way that they look are completely different, or the way that they attack, the way that they, you know, it's just completely different. And seeing them in animation, not just in the manga, absolutely great. Honestly, I think I really love how the Cardcaptor Sakura manga just animates, brings the manga to life. It's something that you don't see in the manga, and Madhouse is just bringing it to life. Everything into action, and I absolutely love that. Not that I don't love the manga, I do love the manga, but it's just something when you watch the anime, and I think Cardcaptor Sakura has this thing where it's something that just has to be animated. Like, it's great to read as well, but it looks so much better when you can see everything in action. So she does capture three cards. She's probably going to capture more throughout the series because she is Cardcaptor Sakura, but honestly, why her cards disappeared? You know, why did they go clear? I don't know, but we do have a mysterious figure that wears a cloak with stars. We don't know anything about this figure and, you know, what they've done, or, you know, why did this happen to Sakura? We have no idea. Now, here's my issue with Lee and Ariel. They clearly know something and are clearly hiding something from Sakura, which is very upsetting because I'm like, she is Cardcaptor Sakura. If something is happening to her, shouldn't you let her know? And we could see that Lee clearly knows something. Ariel clearly knows something, or at least has a hunch about it. And they don't say anything. Even Toya, Sakura's own brother, I think he knows something too, but he's not saying anything. You know, so it's like, we just get this feeling of mystery and like, oh, what are the people, you know, what are they all hiding from her, you know? Not even I know, and I'm curious. I want to know now, so it's just very mystery filled, and I can't wait to unravel this mystery. That being said, those two characters, Lee and Ariel, haven't gotten a lot of screen time. I can forgive Ariel because, you know, he is in England and stuff like that. So, okay, I understand that. But Lee, I feel like he hasn't gotten a lot of screen time, probably because Sakura has been out, you know, capturing new cards and everything. But we haven't seen enough of Lee. So I think, even though there have been many cute moments between Sakura and Lee, and we all ship them now, because, I mean, if you didn't ship them before, now you really ship them, especially that coat sharing scene. Ooh. They're just so cute together. But honestly, like, I think we need to see more of Lee and what, you know, I know that he knows something, so I want to see more of him and what he possibly knows. Another thing to note is also Tomoyo's costumes. Honestly, they are just getting cuter and cuter as the series goes on. Honestly, in episode 3, we see Sakura dressed up in like a frog costume, and it's the cutest thing in the world. So it's so nice to see Tomoyo and Sakura still being best friends and still hanging out, and Tomoyo still filming Sakura, still making Sakura costumes, and I absolutely love their interactions. And the great thing is that at the end of every episode, you actually can see Sakura's costumes as a whole. So they're just so like Sakura in the outfit, and they'll give like a profile shot and everything. So if you want to make the costume yourself, you have a nice view of like what her costume looks like. And I just absolutely love that. Oh, and speaking of references, when they referred to the play in the original Cardcaptor Sakura, that was hilarious. Also, seeing, this is not really so much of a reference, but seeing how Yamazaki, you know, he's still like making stories and Lee and Sakura are still believing him, even though they're the most far-fetched things ever. It's hilarious, and it's funny because sometimes Yamazaki almost got me too. I was like, really? And I was like, no, this can't be true. So it's nice to see that there's still some things from the original in Cardcaptor Sakura Clear Card. The first three episodes were very entertaining. They were vibrant, very nostalgic, very beautiful. It was just such a great first three episodes. I've really been enjoying myself. I don't know, like I said, I don't know why Sakura's cards went transparent, but we will probably find out soon, hopefully. I do have catching up with the manga, but has the second volume been released yet? I have no idea, but if it has been, I'm ordering it today. But yeah, I found the first three episodes to be really, really enjoyable, and if you liked the first three episodes, or if you have any thoughts about the first three episodes of Cardcaptor Sakura Clear Card, feel free to comment below and let me know how you felt about the first three episodes. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you liked this video, and I will see you guys next time.